Now on WRDE Coast TV.
Damaging fires under investigation. What investigators say happened and which fires were possibly weather-related. New housing development proposed here on Zor Road, south of Georgetown. Concerns neighbors are raising. More electric vehicles, more charging stations, but also more frustration. Where to repair the EV problem in Sussex County. Ready for liftoff, just how likely a launch is tomorrow night at Wallops Island.
And a fantastic to the start of the work week here on the coast, but we are concerned about the possibility of coastal flooding. I'll update you on the latest advisories in our area.
From the beaches to the bay, coverage you can count on. WRDE Coast TV, your local news at 11 starts right now.
Good evening. I'm Mallory Metzner. Charlie Sakaitis has the evening off. Welcome to our news at 11. We begin tonight with two weather-related fires under investigation. New at 11, the Worcester County Fire Marshal says severe thunderstorms over the weekend caused two separate fires. The fire marshal says a barn fire was reported around 8:30 Saturday night on Witten Road in Snow Hill. It took around 3 hours for numerous agencies to get that fire under control. Next, the fire marshal says a two-story home caught fire on Clark Avenue in Pocomoke around 10:30 that same night. Crews from multiple agencies spent 2 hours getting the fire under control. Two people were displaced and are being assisted by the American Red Cross. The fire marshal is still working to determine an exact cause for each fire. There is no severe weather threat tonight as we take a live look outside into our Hershey Exteriors camera at the 45th Street Tap House there in Ocean City. But there may be some advisories we still need to be aware of. And our First Alert Chief Meteorologist Paul Williams joins us now with a look at our weather. Good evening, Paul.
Good evening, Mallory. Kind of a residual effect from the storms over the weekend. We're a little bit concerned about low-lying areas. Still, we have a lot of moisture and still some leftover oomph, so to speak, some leftover some scraps, shall we say, from the storms that we have already experienced. We have a coastal flood advisory that is still active for Sussex County. Now, this is going to expire in about 1 hour from now, so this is going to subside here pretty quickly. But we do have an active coastal flood statement that's going to stay active for Tuesday until about 3 o'clock in the morning. So this is going to be extended till about, let's say, 3 more hours longer than, let's say, this one that's over directly over Sussex County. And you can see that we have a couple of spot showers here. Let me move down here. A couple of spot showers that are flaring up along 343 in Cambridge down towards Bucktown, but they're going to dissipate pretty quickly. We have temperatures right now in the 60s and 70s. Coming up, we'll talk more about what to expect for the rest of this work week, which really doesn't come down to any rain, but we'll have some allergy numbers that I got to tell you about, Mallory.
Thank you, Paul. We'll stick around for that. And let's check in on our Coast TV poll. If you tuned in earlier tonight at 5 or 6, you saw Paul out on the beach. And we want to know what your favorite beach is along the coast. So let's take a look at the updated results. Looking at the screen here, the majority earlier tonight was saying Lewis. That's still the case, though these numbers have changed. Now I see Bethany and Fenwick Island has gotten more votes. That's up to 20%. The State Park, my personal favorite, up to 24%. If you haven't voted yet, you can still do so at WRDE.com or on our news app. New at 11, the Maryland State Fire Marshal is still working to determine what caused a pole building fire in Queen Anne's County. Take a look at the extensive damage in this photo. The fire marshal estimates $800,000 in damage. Investigators say it happened on Amber Way in Chestertown around 2 in the morning Saturday, and crews spent about an hour getting the fire under control. No injuries were reported, and the cause is still under investigation. And new at 11, the Maryland State Fire Marshal says a fire in this three-car garage on Greenwood Road in Denton caused $150,000 in damage. Investigators say it happened just after 11 a.m. Friday when an extension cord sparked and made contact with spilled gasoline. No injuries were reported.
I'm Madeline Overturf. Here's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. All systems are go for Tuesday night's Antares rocket launch at Wallops Island. NASA officials say weather conditions are 80% favorable for a Tuesday night launch around 8:30 p.m. A Worcester County canine back on duty after getting distracted by a deer and running off. Sheriffs say Argo was found in the Berlin area safe and sound. The city of Cambridge is considering realigning its wards, the point being to ensure all five wards are equally balanced. To join a realignment committee and tackle the topic, apply to City Council by August 7th. That's a look at just some of the things happening across Delmarva. I'm Madeline Overturf.
A new development is being proposed for Zor Road. The housing development called Rayleigh Farm would bring 646 single-family houses to the area. It would also cover over 300 acres of land. The developer said today that this project would be an active adults community for people 55 and older and is needed for a growing retired population. But neighbors today said the infrastructure simply can't sustain this kind of growth.
The congestion is really bad. Hospitals are not available. You know, there's only one or two in the area. Not enough supermarkets, stuff like that, traffic. It's really bad.
There is a public hearing scheduled for Rayleigh Farm on August 24th. A reminder from DelDOT for any drivers in Georgetown. Patriots Way is set to close between Avenue of Honor and Zor Road starting tomorrow. That closure will go through Wednesday, August 23rd. During that time, DelDOT says crews will be replacing a crossroad pipe. Detours will be in place. New technology always comes with new problems, and electric cars are no different. Here in Sussex County, some drivers are concerned that we don't have enough charging stations. That is set to change, but perhaps a bigger issue is repair shops. Coast TV News spoke to one Tesla owner who shipped his car all the way to North Carolina to get it serviced. And of the dozen or so repair shops we called in Sussex County, only one of them serviced EVs. Meineke is one of the few shops in the county that can change EV tires and check the brakes, but they say that's as far as they can go. Most mechanics aren't trained yet in how to service the cars, and the shops that do service them are both far away and booked for months.
We are not much assistance as far as most of the vehicle maintenance goes. But as far as tires go, we can assist. That is definitely a strong point for us because some places in town don't even want to touch an electronic vehicle.
There is some good news. Most EVs don't need a lot of service other than basic maintenance, and experts tell us education on EVs is improving every day. The federal government has a new website to help people save on their student loans. Under a new plan revised by the Biden administration, some borrowers could see their monthly payments drop to nothing, while others will save money over the course of the loan's lifetime. Chris Wynn breaks it all down.
With federal student loan payments set to resume in October, some borrowers are feeling the pressure.
We'll manage, but we're going to have to tighten it up again.
But relief could be on the way. On Monday, the Department of Education launched a beta website for the Biden administration's new SAVE program, an income-driven plan intended to lower monthly payments and reduce the amount paid back over the lifetime of the loan. Under the new program, income and family size will determine the payments for current and future federal student loan borrowers, with some payments dropping to $0 per month. To qualify for $0 payments, the income threshold has been increased from 150% to 225% of federal poverty guidelines, which translates to an annual income of $32,805 for a single borrower or $67,500 for a family of four. Other borrowers could see their payments cut in half and canceled after at least 10 years of repayment when the program is in full effect next year. The initiative comes after the June Supreme Court decision striking down President Biden's loan forgiveness program.
I'm not going to stop fighting to deliver borrowers what they need.
But the plan still comes at a cost to the federal government. Estimates range from $138 billion to $361 billion over 10 years, depending on how many people sign up. In Washington, I'm Chris Wynn.
An Idaho mother has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole for the murders of two of her children and her husband's first wife. Lori Vallow was found guilty in May of killing her two youngest children. She was also convicted of conspiring to kill her fifth husband's previous wife. The case has included some wild claims that her young children were zombies and that she was a goddess sent to usher in the biblical apocalypse. Vallow faces two more criminal cases in Arizona, one of which she's charged with conspiring to kill her fourth husband, who was shot and killed in 2019. We have a lot more to cover tonight on Coast TV News at 11. Coming up, National Night Out, where you can meet the agencies that protect your community during annual celebrations around Delmarva tomorrow night.
And we take a look at our UV index for tomorrow. It's going to be at a high level, so burn time's going to be 25 minutes. So please keep that in mind as we continue to tell you about the UV index, courtesy of Face of Grace.
But first, presidential pedal power. President Biden and First Lady Jill Biden getting a little exercise in while the president takes some downtime. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Tomorrow at 4 on Coast Life, we're celebrating the historic Lewis Farmers Market Annual Tomato Festival. Then explore the STAT Summer Camp. Plus, learn vital self-defense techniques. Coast Life tomorrow at 4 on Coast TV.
Travel through time to change history for the better.
We can't find him.
Everything's changed.
Where are you, Ben?
Discover your future with Sussex Tech Adult Education. We offer registered apprenticeship and health profession programs and much more, which will prepare you for everything you need to succeed in your new career, providing hands-on experience with classes taught by professionals from every industry. Sussex Tech will assist our graduates in finding their new career opportunity. To learn more about how you can earn your professional credentials that can change your life, check out Sussex Tech Adult Education online.
Your future is waiting for you at Sussex Tech Adult Education.
President Biden is in Rehoboth Beach this week, and today he and the First Lady got in a little exercise. You can see here the first couple riding their bikes, zipping right by the media. A small group of people were on hand to watch and cheer from behind the rope line. There was one shouted question about China and malware, but the president did not respond. He and the First Lady just continued on their way down the trail. House Republicans have started an investigation into Hunter Biden's plea agreement with the Justice Department. GOP members cite a pretrial diversion program that would have asked a judge to decide whether or not the president's son breached the diversion agreement. Republicans also question a clause in the agreement that would have given Hunter Biden immunity from all other crimes for simply completing the pretrial diversion program. Last week, Hunter Biden was scheduled to enter a guilty plea to a pair of tax charges and agree to a pretrial diversion program to avoid a gun charge. The judge said she would defer it. Hunter Biden decided to plead not guilty to the charges, and the plea agreement is now in limbo. A new week and new potential for more indictments for former President Donald Trump. These investigations are overshadowing the race for the White House. But as Alice Barr reports, GOP candidates are doing their best to focus attention on their policies for the country while President Biden takes some downtime.
In a week that could bring major developments in former President Trump's legal troubles.
These are ridiculous indictments.
A new co-defendant in the former president's classified documents case appearing in a Florida court today. Mar-a-Lago property manager Carlos de Oliveira is accused of trying to help Mr. Trump delete security camera footage to obstruct the investigation, allegations the Trump team sharply denies.
What was the obstruction of justice? Because no tapes were deleted. He turned them over. He cooperated, as he always does.
At the same time, we're awaiting word of two more potential Trump indictments, both centered on efforts to overturn the 2020 election. One case in Washington, D.C., the other in Fulton County, Georgia, where security is ramping up.
Some people may not be happy with the decisions that I was making, and sometimes when people are unhappy, they act in a way that could create harm.
The legal cloud hanging over the presidential campaign as Mr. Trump's closest Republican rival, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, is trying to hit reset.
We will usher in a new era of growth, prosperity, and civic pride.
He's under fire for his state's new Black History teaching standards while facing a cash crunch and lagging poll numbers. President Biden at his vacation home in Delaware while on Capitol Hill. His son Hunter's business dealings remain a key focus for House Republicans. Today, hearing closed-door testimony from one of Hunter Biden's former business partners.
There still is no connection of any of Hunter Biden's business dealings with President Biden.
Democrats defending their president and candidate in the next race for the White House. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.
As former President Trump's legal troubles mount, the Washington Post is reporting his political group spent more than $40 million on legal costs in the first half of the year. Despite that, a New York Times poll shows 71% of Republican voters stand behind him amid the investigations.
As you pull out those smartphones, open up that camera app and just scan the QR code down there in the corner of the screen. It'll be up anytime a meteorologist is on screen. And the QR code will send you to your smartphone app where you can download the Coast TV weather app, giving you instant access to Coast TV's first alert weather forecast right at your fingertips. Now, right now, we have a coastal flood advisory that's still active for Sussex County. Now, that's going to stay active at least for the next 45 minutes or so. In addition to that, we also have a newly issued coastal flood statement that's in effect for us throughout places like Lynkwood, Sharptown, Bucktown, Robbins, Cambridge, and Madison, and Golden Hill. This stays in effect until 3 o'clock. Concerned about a little bit of flooding and just simply or predominantly low-lying areas being inundated. That's primarily it. Now, this also includes the Fenwick Island area, also towards Bayard, Frankfort, as well as Shelbyville. But it cuts off at Little Georgetown and any place to the south. We stay clear. Although we've seen some spot showers flare up in Parksley, Hallwood, and Rehoboth. We're not concerned about the flood advisory extending beyond midnight for tonight. Currently, we're holding at 73 degrees, for example, at Rehoboth Beach, as well as Bethany Beach, 71, Millsboro, 71 in Seaford, and 71 right now in Milford. The dew point temperatures in the upper 60s to low 70s. Not quite as muggy as last week, but still muggy enough, right? Now, as you take a look at our future cast, you can see scattered clouds are pushing over throughout the early morning hours. Going to the afternoon, we see the sunshine making a big comeback. So with that being the case, the sunshine is going to be our big story for the next few days. But it's not blazing or burning sunshine like it is in other parts of the country. But we will have an elevated UV index of 10 for Tuesday, Wednesday, and a 9 on Thursday and Friday. So you'll need to be sure to protect yourself with the sunscreen, stay in the shade, limit your outdoor time, and try to avoid the sun between 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. because that's when the peak of the sun and its burning effects is in full effect for us. Winds are pushing out of the north. That's going to help it feel cooler. As we go into, let's say, Tuesday afternoon, we have temperatures in the 70s along the coast, low 80s inland. That's a vacation compared to what everybody else is dealing with in the country with crazy heat. Thursday, we're looking at the same situation for us, 70s in the morning time. Now, what is indeed going up is our sneeze cast. The grass is at a high level. Listen, don't be surprised if our sneeze cast really begins to elevate significantly for us over the next few days, because that's going to be one of our biggest stories, because these temperatures are starting in the 60s and dancing into the low 80s. That's going to be comfortable, easy living compared to what we've been dealing with. So mostly clear for the night, 84 for tomorrow, manageable warmth, and then bearable, not unbearable, but bearable heat on Wednesday. Here's a look at your Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling extended forecast. 40% chance of rain on Thursday, 60% chance of rain on Friday.
Thank you, Paul. Still to come in sports, the Delmarva Sports Network will have the playoff action in Summer League hoops. And bilingual police officer shortage, the police department in our area trying to bridge the communication gap, and where the community can have a night out with law enforcement during an annual initiative tomorrow.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now get 3.9% financing for 60 months plus $1,500 bonus cash on F-150 and F-150 Lightning.
Summer is here. Finally some sun, good weather, and quality time with the children. But no matter what you plan, they always find ways to get hurt. But I'm not worried. I have Your Docs In to take care of any problems. We just walk in and they make everything comfortable and easy. Now we are ready. Summer, here we go. Your Docs In. Feel better faster. The beach is waiting.
Sun, sand, and summertime style at H&H Furniture and Appliances in Pocomoke. Dive into our huge in-stock selection to refresh your home. Ask about our prompt delivery and up to 24-month interest-free financing. Discover our charming children's selection. Try out our full range of Serta mattresses, America's number one mattress brand. Browse appliances that you can depend on, like Speed Queen. And trust our professional and experienced installation and service team. Make your home a reflection of you at H&H Furniture and Appliances in Pocomoke.
The Georgetown Police Department is looking to hire police officers, but they are in critical need of bilinguals. Census data shows 39% of Georgetown's population is Hispanic or Latino, and yet the department only has one full-time bilingual officer for thousands of people in town who don't speak English. Chief Ralph W. Holm Jr. says how important it is to have a bilingual officer in their department.
To best handle our calls for service to our Hispanic community, we have to be able to have somebody who speaks the language fluently so that we get the best information that we have. The only way to do that is have bilingual officers.
The Georgetown Police Department will have applications for people to fill out tomorrow at National Night Out at the Richard Allen School from 6 to 8 p.m. National Night Out is a community event that aims to cultivate safe communities and a good relationship between people and law enforcement. Here are the communities celebrating National Night Out in our area tomorrow: the city of Lewis, the towns of Laurel and Blades, Greenwood and Milford, and Ocean City. We have an article on our website that explains what each of these National Night Out celebrations will have for people to do and what time and where they take place. More problems for the company formerly known as Twitter. X has been given a notice of violation in the city of San Francisco due to their giant, bright, some might say obnoxious, X on the top of their building. The social media platform recently installed the new flashing X sign at its headquarters. The complaint says the new sign was placed without a permit. According to a recent report, that light is now being taken down. City officials had attempted to inspect the roof area twice, but were denied access.
Delmarva Sports Network from the Wawa Studios.
Some of the basketball highlights: Delmar taking on Brandon's Junk Removal from Snow Hill. Cats looking to keep their playoff hopes alive in Southeast Maryland Summer League action. First half, Jerron Cannon, he's going to start things off for the Blue and Orange from downtown. His first three ball ties things up at three apiece. Later in the first, Cats up three. Emmanuel Ortiz, like his mac and cheese, crafty move. Del Mar by five now. This season's shore basketball, though, folks, advantage the height. And the trees from Snow Hill causing problems underneath. Cameron Lucas will get the tip in for the third chance bucket. And then later, great ball reversal once again from Tyler Ball. It's DeMar Brunson. We'll skip to Maya Liu. Nice hop step into the lane. To the second half we go. Great inbounds play drawn up from Danny Lamb's guys. It's Dustin Peterson. He's been impressive all summer long. Good lay in there. Brandon Junk removal unfazed. Long rebound for Tyler Ball. We've been seeing this for years now. One man fast break to the cup. Delmar would battle back to tie it on Cam Groon's triple from the wing, but Brandon's Junk removal walk away with the win, 39-28. Snow Hill moves on to play Decatur in the next round. Meanwhile, still hope for the Delaware squads. Laurel got a first round by the Dogs. They take on Team Persevere, a.k.a. James M. Bennett, and that game coming up on Friday. I'll do it for Sports Tonight.
A not-so-sweet mess today in California. A semi-truck carrying 40,000 pounds of chocolate caught on fire this morning in Colfax. That's in the northern portion of the state. As you can imagine, this turned the transport truck into a melting mess on the side of the road. The good news is that no one was injured, but traffic was temporarily shut down while the pile of chocolate and remains that you can see in this video of the truck were moved off the road. No word yet on how the sugary sweets caught fire. The hidden dangers of alcohol, the link a new study found between alcohol consumption and being more sensitive to pain. And helping pet owners care for the fur babies, the free wellness clinics your four-legged family members can take advantage of in Sussex County.
Now at Hardee's, two hand-breaded chicken tender wraps are only $5. Choose one of five flavors for endless combinations, including new Nashville Hot. Two wraps, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Redesigned from the ground up and engineered for adventure, the new Tundra is Toyota's toughest, most advanced truck to date, outfitted to help tackle any terrain with reliability only Toyota is known for. Now electrified with available iForce Max powertrain and one of the top 10 cars with best resale value according to KBB.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Hi, I'm Joel Wharton, Sussex County farmer. Don't wait until after harvest to plant your cover crops. Consider broadcasting or interseeding cover crops into your standing cash crop. Early establishment provides more growth potential and more soil armor over winter. It also saves time because after harvest, the cover crop is already growing and protecting the soil, cycling nutrients, and preventing erosion. To learn more about the benefits and ways to establish cover crops early, contact the Sussex Conservation District because every acre counts.
Living a good life means being healthy. But what does it mean to be healthy and stay healthy? It means getting the right kind of care, right here, and convenient. It means having the right hospital to coordinate the delivery of healthcare for the entire community. Atlantic General Hospital. We'll put you on the right path to good health and keep you there.
Thinking about upgrading your bath or shower? Bath by Spicer Brothers is making it easy with a limited time offer.
Right now, receive $1,000 off your new shower or bath. Save 50% off installation, plus 0% financing with no payments until 2025.
Choose your favorite style and color, and it can be installed in as little as one day.
Have peace of mind with our Platinum Plus lifetime warranty and factory-certified 5-star installation guaranteed.
So before you sign, keep Bath by Spicer Brothers in mind.
Make dinner good tonight with Hardee's new chicken tender platters. Crunchy, juicy tenders all dipped in buttermilk and hand-breaded with a thick slice of garlicky Texas toast, seasoned crinkle fries, slaw, and choice of sauce. Hardee's, goodness in the making.
New at 11, furry friends in need can get up to date on their vaccines for free at two upcoming wellness and vaccination clinics. This video is from the Humane Animal Partners Free Wellness Clinic that was held last month in Georgetown at the Cheer Community Center. The organization says two more are planned in August. The first will be held on August 10th from 11 to 2 at Goodwill in Bridgeville. The second is on August 16th from 3 to 6 in Georgetown at First State Community Action Agency. Both clinics are first come, first serve. According to the CDC, more than half of Americans aged 18 and older regularly consume alcohol, and nearly 17% of adults binge drink. But too much alcohol can cause more problems than you might realize.
I hope this book has given you a pathway to the life that you deserve.
Alcohol used to be a big part of Veronica Valli's life.
My drinking was very chaotic and dangerous from when I was about 15 years old.
Like many, Veronica accepted her excessive drinking until she realized it was holding her back. Research shows about 15 million Americans struggle with an alcohol use problem, but only 10% receive help. Excessive alcohol use is linked to an increased risk of injuries, chronic diseases, cancer, and poor pregnancy outcomes.
People can spend 10 years from the moment they wake up and think, oh, there's something wrong with my drinking, to actually stopping.
Pain is another side effect of alcohol. More than half of people with an alcohol use disorder experience some type of persistent pain. In a new British study, researchers found chronic alcohol consumption may make people more sensitive to pain through two different molecular mechanisms, one driven by alcohol intake and one driven by alcohol withdrawal.
I discover everything I thought about sobriety and drinking was completely wrong. So I thought sobriety was boring. That's what our culture tells us.
Veronica finally decided to get sober at age 27 and hasn't looked back. It's funny
how that. The number one thing I want people to know is that when you stop drinking, you don't give up anything. You don't miss out on anything. just the opposite.
Now, she's a recovery coach and therapist helping others break free from alcohol addiction.
Veronica says the number one mistake people make when trying to stop drinking is doing it alone. She says it's important to find a community of support. The Biden administration is hoping researchers can find answers to the problem known as long COVID. The White House announced today it is establishing a new office within the Department of Health and Human Services to lead the federal government's response. The agency will launch clinical trials for long COVID patients to try to figure out how to treat it. It is estimated up to 23 million people in the country are dealing with long COVID. Scientists say more than 200 symptoms are associated with long COVID and can affect nearly every part of the body. That includes the heart, lungs, stomach, and immune systems. It is time to take another look at our Coast TV poll tonight. We asked, what's your favorite beach around here? Take a look at the screen. The majority have been saying Lewis. That's still in first place at 33%, but if you haven't voted yet, you can still do so on our website or our mobile app. Run for the Paws, how you and your four-legged friend can get some exercise in, all for a cause this weekend. Stay tuned on Coast TV News at 11.
Delmarva's rock station for 35 years.
Chill out and win big at Ocean Downs with Coolers of Cash. Every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday, you can win cash or free play, plus a finalist entry for our final drawing on August 26th. Ocean Downs Casino, where the fun shines.
The world's number one selling farm tractor. Easy to operate and more powerful than your average tractor. Mahindra tractors. Push more, pull more, lift more. With more torque and lower engine maintenance, Mahindra tractors are rugged and tough. We know how much you love your land, so we want you to love your tractor. Get your next Mahindra tractor today. Southern States of Milford, improving farming and improving life. Rooted since 1948.
Sam Calagione from Dogfish Head here, inviting you to join us in downtown Rehoboth Beach at our brew pub, Brewings and Eats, and at our seafood and cocktail spot, Chesapeake and Main. Grab a Brewpub exclusive on the patio and indulge in a wood-fired burger or pizza, or enjoy an inventive cocktail with fresh seafood from our raw bar. Come visit Dogfish Head in downtown Rehoboth Beach. Cheers.
Get hooked on the freshness with Harbor House Seafood. Since 1984, Harbor House in Seaford has been your one-stop shop for the freshest local seafood. Plus, we have amazing prime black Angus beef as well. From land to sea, surf and turf has never been this fresh. Come see our seasonal selection in person or online at harborhouseseafood.com. Harbor House Seafood, your surf and turf market in Seaford, Delaware.
Hey, bath guy, do you do roofs?
Nope.
Do you do lawns?
Negatory.
Do you do windows and siding?
Not a chance.
At Peninsula Bath, we're your local pros for bathroom remodeling, and that's it. Top quality, customer focus, and competitively priced. Ask about our free shower door upgrade and our neediest bathroom contest.
Hey, Dad, can you take out the trash?
No, son, not a chance.
Peninsula Bath.
Two kids now. It's all you got. Baby, come on.
This must be
Sunkiss Summer Mixtape on 102.5 WBOC.
Brought to you by Bass by Spicer Brothers.
Racers will take their mark on two legs and four at the Run for the Paws in Dewey Beach on Saturday morning. The 15th annual race starts at 7:30 a.m. at the Dewey Beach Lions Club. There's a 5K run and 1 mile pet friendly walk. This event benefits the Humane Animal Partners.
Take a look at our Paul Davis Restoration winner and our umbrella giveaway winners, Robert Tarpley of Bridgeville. Congratulations, courtesy of Paul Davis Restoration, a home remodeling. Here's a look at the exclusive 10-day forecast. 84 for both Tuesday and Wednesday, going into Thursday and Friday, but will maintain a 40% chance of rain for Thursday, 60% chance of rain on Friday. But the weekend is looking better because we're looking at about 88 for both days, partly cloudy skies. Then we'll click back over into the 90s as we go into Monday and Tuesday of next week. But we are looking at limited amount of rain. So even though we have some active flood or coastal flood advisories or statements that are active right now. They're not going to stay in effect. It looks like we're going to begin to dry out nicely, particularly after good past Thursday and Friday. Then we'll go into the 90s for next Monday and Tuesday and stay in the upper 80s to low 90s following that. That's a good look at your 10-day forecast. And please remember that grass, the ragweed and cut grass is going to be elevated with our pollen index.
Thank you, Paul, and thanks for joining us here for Coast TV News at 11. For more news and local weather, download our Coast TV News app. The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon is up next, and we'll see you tomorrow for Coast TV News at 5 a.m. Have a great night.